The question that I get from a lot of my pre-med students is, what's the relevance of the history of medicine to contemporary practice? And I think of the history of medicine as embedded in the DNA of contemporary medical science and medical practice. In order to know who we are and what we're doing, we absolutely have to know where we came from. Well, in its development over the last 3,000 years, medical science has explored ever more intensively the hidden landscape beneath our skin. It's done so in order to understand, to enhance, and to preserve the well-being of the human body. Anna Morandi lived in the 18th century, 1714 to 1774. She's important because she defied low social status, limited formal education, and all of those biases against her sex to become one of the most important anatomists of her age and the most important anatomical modeler of the European Enlightenment. Catherine the Great was obsessed with her. Pope Benedict XIV was her primary patron, and people flocked from all over Europe to witness her home studio. Bologna, in the middle of the 18th century, resurges as a center of science. Anna Morandi, in partnership with her husband, and they really were true partners. Both of them are professionally trained artists, and they collaborate to open a home studio of anatomy and anatomical wax modeling. Anna Morandi's husband tragically dies. She then takes over the anatomy studio and continues her dissection of hundreds and hundreds of cadavers. The two main themes of Anna Morandi's opus were the sensory organs, which were critical to the contemporary discourse about perception and cognition. How do we know what we know? The other theme was the reproductive body. The female body had always been seen in every part and facet, driven toward the reproduction of the human species. She looks at the male body as having the same reproductive imperative. That is pretty extraordinary for a woman whose primary patron is also the Pope. My background is in Italian literature. While I was studying the anatomical waxworks of Anna Morandi, I really wanted to have a more hands-on understanding of what her hands were touching. And it became more and more important to me to take a class in gross anatomy. And as you're peeling back the skin and seeing all of these structures and their attachments and the color and how it all works, it was sort of miraculous. For all the good of technology and medical science, data-driven information, you have to keep the human being at the center of the medical experience, and that is the aim of medical humanities.